lapse of memory. We are doing this lesson, and you know that Bipin Chaudhary, when he was coming to home, he went to his friend Kali Charan's bookshop to buy a few books, and just then there a man was observing him very closely, and he told Bipin Babu that he went to Ranchi, and he gave some proof also. But Bipin Babu did not remember about his visit to Ranchi. And then, sir, I have done this chapter, Mahima. Okay. Then when he was coming home, then Parimal Ghosh gave him many proof that you visited Ranchi. And he gave him his personal information about his family and about his brother, about his wife, but Bipin Babu could not remember. Then Bipin Babu remembered that he spent 1958 years October month in a puja with a friend in Kanpur. And then when he reached home, he remembered that Parimal Ghosh said that Dinesh Mukherjee was also with him. Dinesh Mukherjee was also with him, and he told him that you can ask him, you can confirm from him, and we were doing this. And he also told him that you had a cut mark, mark of injury on your right leg. And Bipin Babu on the way rolled up his trouser and tried to see if it was really there. We can see in the picture, and he found a injury mark, an inch long injury mark also. Still he did not remember anything. Still he was worried if he went there or not. Okay, then after reaching home, he tried to remember if he went there. He was not getting comfort. Then he thought that I should ask my friend with whom I spent my October month in puja, and he is Haridas. But he found that that man had gone to Japan and he did not have his address. So we came to know that Bipin Babu, he wanted to first of all confirm from Dinesh Mukherjee, but he could not confirm. He wanted to call him. First of all, he decided to go to his home, but he thought that he will make fun of him, that Bipin Babu, you are going, was going nut. Was going nut here means he was going mad. He was becoming crazy. We have read up to this point yesterday. Am I right? Okay. Nirav, yahi tak padha tha beta kal humne? Yes, Nirav, unmute yourself. Yahi tak padha tha beta kal? Okay. Riddhi Siddhi, beta, write your query in the chat box. If you have any query, Riddhi Siddhi, write in chat box. Don't disturb, please. And I am going to unmute Mahima. Mahima, unmute yourself and read.
Yes, sir.
Read from here. And he knew
the man,
and he knew how ruthless Dinesh Sarkajam could be. From here, from this sentence.
Okay, sir. And he knew how ruthless Dinesh Sarkajam could be. Sipping a cold drink in his air-conditioned living room, Bipin Babu felt at ease again. Such a nonsense. Just because they have nothing else to do, they go about getting into other people's hair. After dinner, snuggling in bed with one of new thrillers, Bipin Babu forgot all about the men in the new market.
Yes, beta. And he knew how ruthless Dinesh Sarkajam could be. Here, ruthless means without any pity. He would be very cruel. Dinesh sarcasm. Sarcasm means taunt. You can say funny joke. He will make fun of him. Sipping a cold drink in his dry air-conditioned living room, Bipin Babu felt at ease again. He was feeling comfortable again, but just then he thought about the incident of the bookstore, Parimal Ghosh's proof that he had visited to Ranchi. Such a nuisance. Nuisance means troublesome, a great trouble. He thought that it is very troublesome. Just because they have nothing else to do. He thought that people have nothing else to do. That's why they are making fun of me. They are playing this prank. Okay, he thought this. Bipin Babu is thinking that some people are playing prank on him. Just they had nothing to do. That's why they go about getting into other people's hair. Getting into other people's hair meaning is given interfering with and annoying. Their meaning is given. They are interfering in others' personal matter and they are annoying others also. Okay. Then, let's see. After dinner, snuggling in bed, after taking his dinner, Bipin Babu, he was snuggling in bed with one of the new thriller. Snuggling means he was very comfortable. He was warming. He was very comfortable in his bed. And he was reading one new thriller, new novel of thrill, new novel of romance. Bipin Babu forgot all about the man in New Market. He forgot about that man in the New Market, Parimal Ghosh, who told him about the Ranchi tour. Okay, let's see what happened in the what happened next day. Next day, in the office, Bipin Babu. Let me scroll it. Khushi Batra, unmute yourself. Khushi.
Yes, sir.
Unmute yourself and read this full page up to 58 from next day.
Next day, in the office, Bipin Babu noticed that with every passing hour, the previous days. Encounter was occupying more and more of his mind. If the man knew so much about Bipin Babu,
keep on reading, Khushi. Okay, Khushi has went somewhere. Megha, you unmute yourself. Megha, okay, Khushi, you are back. Are you going to read? Yes, Khushi.
Yes, sir.
Read.
If the man knew so much about Bipin Babu, how could he make such a mistake about the Ranchi trip? Just before lunch, Bipin Babu decided to ring up Dinesh Mukherjee. It was better to settle the question over the phone. At least the embarrassment on his face wouldn't show. 2, 3, 5, 6, 1, 6.
Okay, beta, let me read. Khushi is busy somewhere. Next day in the office, Bipin Babu noticed that with every passing hour, the previous day's encounter was occupying more and more his mind. So in the office, when he reached in the office, he was working with after passing of every hour, the previous day's encounter. Encounter means when he met Parimal Ghosh face to face, means meeting unexpectedly. He met Parimal Ghosh suddenly. That is called encounter. Aamna samna hona. Mudbed ho jana. Ek aur encounter hota jo police encounter karti hai. But yahan pe encounter ka matlab hota hai milna. To meet someone unexpectedly. Okay. Jab pata bhi nahi tha kisi se mulaqat hogi. Occupying more and more of his mind means these thoughts were coming in his mind again and again. He's thinking, if the man knew so much about Bipin Babu, if that man knew about him so much, how could he make such a mistake about the Ranchi trip? Then he could not make any mistake about the Ranchi trip. Just before lunch, Bipin Babu decided to ring up Dinesh Mukherjee. Here, ring up means to make phone call. It was better to settle the question over the phone. He thought that with the phone call, I will confirm from Dinesh Mukherjee. At least the embarrassment on his face would not show. When we call on the phone, when we make a call, other person cannot see our face reaction. So he thought that when I call Dinesh Mukherjee, if I am feeling embarrassment means insulting, then he will not know about it if I call him. Ria, would you read? Ria, unmute yourself. Ria, 8th pearl. Yes, beta. Read.
Yes, sir.
Yes, read from here, 2, 3, 5.
Two, three, five, six, one, six. Bipin Babu dialed the number. Hello, is that Dinesh? That is Bipin here. Well, well. Who's? I just wanted to find out if you recall an incident with the aid.
One student is asking the meaning of embarrassment. Embarrassment means feeling insult. Okay. Besti mehsoos karna. Insult. Bipin Babu dialed number 2, 3, 5, 6, 1, 6. And he said, hello, is that Dinesh? This is Bipin here. Well, well, what's the news? I just wanted to find out if you recalled an incident which took place in 58. Here, 58 means 1958. Okay, he wanted to confirm about that. Let's see what happened then. Let me clear and scroll this. Next page, open your book on next page. Priyanshi is back. We are on page number 65 now. 58, what incident? Were you in Calcutta? Calcutta, right? Through that year, he wanted to know, was Dinesh Mukherjee in Calcutta in that year? That's the first thing I have got to know. I wanted to know this thing. Wait just a minute. 58, just let me check in my diary. He told that I will check in my diary. Then I will tell you, let me check in my diary. For a minute, there was silence. Bipin Babu could feel that his heartbeat had gone up. He felt that his heartbeat was increasing. He was sweating. Okay, he was sweating. Here, sweating means he was perspiring. Pasino raha tha. A little, hello, yes, I have got it. I have been out twice. He told him that he went out two times. Where? Once in February, nearby to Krishna Nagar, to a nephew's wedding. So Dinesh Mukherjee told him that one time he went in February to attend his nephew's wedding. And then, but you would know about this one. Aapko bhi pata hoga iske bare mein. The trip to Ranchi. I went to Ranchi. You were there too. Aap bhi wahan the. That's all. But what's all this sleuthing about? Sleuthing hota hai means investigating. Meaning is given in your book also. No, I just wanted to anyway, thanks. Bipin Babu kehta, I just wanted to confirm. I just wanted to know. Were you there or not? Then Bipin Babu slammed the receiver down and gripped his head with his hands. Bipin Babu, he slammed the receiver. Slammed means put with a noise, loud noise, and gripped his head with his hand. Again, he was feeling tension. He was nervous. He felt his head swimming. He felt that his head was giddy, or he was feeling headache, or you can say he was feeling dizziness. Uska sir chakra raha tha. A chill seemed to spread over his body. A chill means a cold wave went through his body, through his spine, through his backbone. There were sandwiches. He took sandwiches in his tiffin box, but he did not eat them. He had lost his appetite. Appetite means bhook. उसने उसकी भूख मारी गई थी. He did not have any appetite. Appetite means hunger. He did not have any hunger. कहते ना आज मुझे भूख नहीं है. He was not feeling hungry. So he had lost his appetite. And in this way, this second part is over. And now I am going to start third part of the story. And I hope you will join this. You will participate in it and understand the concept. After lunch time, Bipin Babu realized that he couldn't possibly carry on sitting at his desk and working. This had never happened in the 25 years he had been with the firm. He had a reputation for being a good worker. So what happened after lunch time? After lunch time, Bipin Babu realized that he could not possibly carry on sitting at his desk. Means he could not work in the office now, because the same thought was coming in his mind that if he had went to Ranchi, how he can forget that? This had never happened in the 25 years. He had been with the firm. Firm means a company of having two or more than two partners. He had a reputation for being a good worker. उसकी कैसी रेपुटेशन थी कंपनी के अंदर? टायरलेस, कंसेंचुअस वर्कर. ही वाज ए मीनिंग इज गिवन केयरफुल एंड करेक्ट. ही वाज केयरफुल एंड करेक्ट वर्कर एंड एवरीबडी प्रेज हिम, एप्रिशिएट हिम, इवन हिज बॉस, इवन हिज अदर कोलीग्स, दे प्रेज हिम. यू कैन फाइंड द मीनिंग ऑफ कंसेंचुअस हियर, केयरफुल एंड करेक्ट. And but today his head was in a whirl. Mahima will tell the meaning of this word. His head was in a whirl. Mahima has read the lesson. Mahima, unmute yourself. Priyanshi is sitting with his younger brother. Yes, Gupta has raised his hand. Okay, Mahima, can you unmute yourself? What about other? They have stop their video. Don't stop your video. Start your video. Mahima is unable to unmute herself. Priyanshi, what is the meaning of his head was in a whirl? It is given in the book also. Can you find? Priyanshi, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
What is the meaning of his head was in a whirl?
Confused and unable to think clearly.
Yes, he was very much confused and he was not able to think clearly, properly. Okay. Read this next paragraph, Priyanshi. Back home. From here. Read this paragraph. You are mute. Mute hai beta, Priyanshi. Mute hai. Apne aapko unmute kare pehle. Unmute kare beta.
Back home at 2:30, Bipin Babu lay down in bed and tried to gather his wits together. He knew that it was possible to lose one's memory through an injury in the head, but he didn't know of a single instance of someone remembering everything except one particular incident, and a fairly recent and significant one at that. He had always wanted to go to Ranchi, to have gone there, done things, and not to remember was something utterly impossible.
Yes, beta, good. Thank you. Back home at 2:30. When he came back to home at 2:30, Bipin Babu lay down in bed and he tried to gather his wit together. Tried to gather his wit together, meaning is given here. Make an effort to become calm and think clearly. He tried to calm himself. Don't raise your hand if you have any query. Just write in chat box. And one student is there without any name and he is raising his hand. Shall I remove you? The student who is raising his hand, you have not written even your name. Yes, who is that boy? Rename yourself, beta, boy or girl. don't enter the class without your name. Yes, beta, he knew that it was possible to lose one's memory. Gathered his wit together means make an effort to become calm and think clearly. He wanted to think clearly. He knew that it was possible to lose one's memory through an injury in the head. We have read somewhere or seen in the movies that if there is an injury in the head, a person can lose his memory. But he did not know a single instance of someone remembering everything except one particular incident. But Bipin Babu, he had forgotten only one particular incident. केवल एक incident भूल गया था, and a fairly recent and significant one at that. He had always wanted to go to Ranchi. He always planned to go to Ranchi. To have gone there, done things, and not to remember was something utterly impossible. It was very, it was not possible for him to forget about Ranchi trip. So in the evening, let's see what happened. At 7:30, Bipin Babu's servant came and announced. His servant came and told him, "Chunni Babu, sir says it's very important." So who came to meet Bipin Babu? Chunni Babu. He came to meet and he says it's very important. Bipin Babu knew what Chunni had come for. He already knew why Chunni had come. Chunni Lal had been at school with him. Means Chunni Lal was his classmate, his class fellow. Okay, he was his classmate, class fellow or schoolmate. He had been having a rough time lately. उसका बुरा time चल रहा था. Having a rough time meaning is given here. Having a lot of problems. He was having a lot of problems. Bipin Babu knew it was not possible to do anything for him, and in fact told him so, but Chunni kept turning up like a bad penny. Bipin Babu had clearly told him that I could not help you, it is not possible to do anything for you, but Chunni Lal was coming again and again. He was asking, just like if we are having some coin and the bad penny is coming to us again and again, बार बार खोटा सिक्का ही सामने आता ना, उसी टाइप से चुन्नी लाल जो है बार बार उसके पास आ रहा था. ये मीनिंग इज गिवन टर्निंग अप लाइक बैड पैनी, मीनिंग इज गिवन अपीयरिंग एट ए प्लेस वेयर वन इज नॉट वेलकम. वो ऐसी जगह पे आ रहा था जहाँ पे उसका वेलकम नहीं हो रहा था. ही वॉज नॉट वेलकम. बिपिन बाबू कुड नॉट हेल्प हिम. Bipin Babu sent word that not only was it not possible for him to see Chunni now, but not in several weeks. So Bipin Babu sent the message that it is not possible to meet Chunni Lal right now, and he will not be able to meet him for coming several weeks. आने वाले कुछ सप्ताह तक भी नहीं मिल पाएगा. Okay. Once unmute yourself and read the remaining portion of this page from here. But as soon as once ने unmute किया अपने आप को. Okay बेटा, read.
But as soon as the servant stepped out of the room, it struck Bipin Babu that Chunni might remember something about the 58 trip. There was no harm in asking him. Bipin Babu hurried down the stairs and into the living room. Chunni was about to leave, but seeing Bipin Babu appear, turned around. Hopefully, Bipin Babu did not beat about the bush. Listen, Chunni, I want to ask you something. You have a good memory and you have been seeing me and on for a long time. Just throw your mind back and tell me, did I go to Ranchi in 58? Chunni said, 58. I must have been 58 or was 59.
Okay. So, but as soon as the servant stepped out of the room, when servant was going, it struck Bipin Babu. Struck means it came to his mind. He remembered something. He got an idea. that Chunni might remember something about the 58 trip. हो सकता है कि चुन्नी को 58 के रांची के ट्रिप के बारे में कुछ याद हो. मैं तो भूल गया हूँ, देर बाद नो हाँ मैं नाच के ही. उसको पूछने में कोई बुराई नहीं थी. बेपिन बाबू हरी डाउन द स्टेयर्स एंड इन टू द लिविंग रूम. ही क्लाइम डाउन द स्टेयर्स हरिडली एंड ही केम टू द लिविंग रूम एंड देर ही सो दैट चुन्नी वॉज अबाउट टू लीव. चुन्नी जाने ही वाला था. बट सीइंग बेपिन बाबू अपीयर ही टर्न्ड राउंड होपफुली. बट जब उसने देखा कि बेपिन बाबू आ रहा है, उसने सोचा कुछ मुझे काम दे देगा, क्योंकि चुन्नीलाल को काम की तलाश थी. आजकल जो उसका अच्छा दिन नहीं चल रहे थे, बुरे दिन चल रहे थे. ही डिड नॉट हैव वर्क और मनी, सो ही हैड कम टू बेपिन बाबू फॉर हेल्प. बट बेपिन बाबू हैड टोल्ड हिम दैट ही कुड नॉट हेल्प हिम. सो बेपिन बाबू डिड नॉट बीट अबाउट द बुश. ये देखिए मीनिंग दे रखा, डिड नॉट बीट अबाउट द बुश means he came straight to the point. सीधा point पे आ गया. इधर उधर की बात नहीं की उसने. He did not give any introduction. उसने कोई introduction नहीं दी. Just came to the point. Listen Chunni, I want to ask you something. You have a good memory. आपकी याददाश्त अच्छी है. And you have been seeing me off and on for a long time. आप मुझे काफी time से जानते हैं. Just throw your mind back. जरा याद करना back में. Tell me, did I go to Ranchi in 58? तो क्या मैं 58 में रांची गया था? चुन्नी said, 58, it must have been 58 or was it 59? उसको भी confirm नहीं था. वो कहते 58 में था या 59 में? मुझे confirm नहीं है. Let me remember something about. Let's go to next page. And in my book, it's page number 67. You are sure that I did not go to Ranchi? Sarthik Tomar, unmute yourself and read till I.
You are sure that I did go to Ranchi? Chunni's look and was with the word. Did you have doubt about going at all? Do you remember clearly? Chunni sat down on the sofa to Bepin a long, hard stare and said, Bepin, have you taken drugs or anything? As far as I know, you had a clean record.
Okay, beta. Let me read. You are sure that I did not go to Ranchi? Kya aapko pakka pata hai ki main Ranchi nahi gaya? Chunni look of amazement was not unmixed with worry. Chunni was looking at Bepin Babu with amazement, with surprise, with astonishment, and it was mixed with worry also. Okay. Do you mean you have doubts about having gone at all? क्या आपको doubt है? Did I? Bepin Babu पूछते क्या मैं गया था? Did you remember clearly? Chunni sat down on the sofa, fixed Bepin Babu with a long, hard stare. He started looking continuously at Bepin Babu. Bepin, have you taken to drugs? कि आपने नशीली दवाई ले ली है सब कुछ या कुछ और गड़बड़ है? शराब वगैरह तो नहीं पी के आए आज? As far as I know, you had a clean record. आपका अच्छा रिकॉर्ड है, आपकी मेमोरी अच्छी है. Where such things were concerned, I know that old friendship don't mean much to you. मुझे पक्का पता है कि जो पुरानी दोस्ती है उसका तो कोई महत्व नहीं है आपके लिए. बट एटलीस्ट यू हैड ए गुड मेमोरी. बट आपकी जो मेमोरी है वो बहुत अच्छी है. यू हैव ए शार्प मेमोरी. यू कांट रियली मीन दैट यू हैव फॉरगॉटन अबाउट द रांची ट्रिप. आप ऐसे कैसे कह सकते हैं कि आप रांची की ट्रिप के बारे में भूल गए हो? बेपिन बाबू हैड टू टर्न अवे फ्रॉम चुन्नीज इन क्रूडलुअस स्टेयर. बेपिन चुन्नी लाल वाज स्टेयरिंग एट बेपिन बाबू अनबिलीवेबल. Incredulous means unbelievably, जैसे उसको विश्वास नहीं हो रहा था कि बेपिन बाबू भूल सकते हैं. Incredulous meaning is given or not? No, its meaning is unbelievable. He did not believe what बेपिन बाबू BELIEVABLE unbelievable. He could not remember. He could not believe that. Chunni could, Bepin Babu could forget all the things. Do you remember what my last job was? Asked Chunni. Chunni Lal पूछता है कि आपको याद है मेरी पिछली जॉब क्या थी, मैं पिछली बार क्या काम करता था? Of course, you worked in a travel agency. वो कहता है हाँ, आप travel agency में काम करते थे. You remember that and you don't remember that it was I who fixed up your railway booking for Ranchi. आपको ये तो याद है कि मैं travel agency में काम करता था, बट आपको ये याद नहीं कि मैंने आपकी रेलवे बुकिंग की थी रांची के लिए. आई वेंट टू द स्टेशन टू सी यू ऑफ वन ऑफ द फैंस इन योर कंपार्टमेंट वाज नॉट वर्किंग. आई गोट एन इलेक्ट्रीशियन टू फिक्स इट. सो व्हेन आई वेंट टू सी यू ऑफ इन द ट्रेन कंपार्टमेंट वन फैन वाज नॉट वर्किंग एंड आई गोट एन इलेक्ट्रीशियन आल्सो. हैव यू फॉरगॉटन एवरीथिंग? वट एवर इज द मैटर विद यू? आपके साथ क्या हुआ? यू डोंट लुक टू वेल. आपकी तबीयत भी ठीक नहीं लग रही. यू नो कहीं सठिया तो नहीं गए, पागल तो नहीं हो गए? बेपिन बाबू साइड एंड सुख हिज हेड. कहते नो नो, आई हैव बीन वर्किंग टू हार्ड, मैं सोच रहा हूँ. ही सेड एट लास्ट दैट मस्ट बी द रीजन. यही कारण हो सकता है. यू आर थिंकिंग टू मच. आप ज्यादा सोच रहे हैं. यू आर टू मच वरीड. मस्ट सी अबाउट कंसल्टिंग ए स्पेशलिस्ट. आपको किसी स्पेशलिस्ट से मिलना चाहिए. मस्ट सी अबाउट कंसल्टिंग ए स्पेशलिस्ट. Doubtless, it was Bepin conditions which made Chunni Lal leave without mentioning anything about his job. Bepin ki condition dekhke Chunni Lal jo hai apni job ke bare mein koi baat kiye bina hi wahan se chala gaya. Ab jo hai Bepin Babu meeting over hone wali hai beta, class over hone wali hai. Bepin Babu jo hai apne doctor ko bulayega. Presh Chanda is the name of the physician. Presh Chanda was a young physician with a pair of bright eyes and a sharp nose. He became thoughtful when he heard about Bepin Babu's symptoms. When he came to know about Bepin Babu's symptoms, look, Dr. Chanda, said Bepin Babu desperately. He said, you must cure me of this horrible illness. I can't tell you how it is affecting my work. He told his friend Presh Chanda that I forget something and you must cure of this, and I am suffering from my work also. I could not work properly. Please cure me, give me medicine. Please give me proper medicine so that my memory will